Good morning and welcome to a new feature that we have on the city's web channel. We're starting a new program called the City Council Report. My name is Mike Klinghammer. I am currently the City Council President. And we're going to be doing these reports twice a month on the first and third Wednesday of each month following the council meetings. What we're doing is an attempt to keep everyone up to date on what's going on within your city and give a report about activities that happened at Tuesday night's council meeting. First thing that we did last night was we had quite a discussion about whether or not we should have pigs as pets within the city limits. This is it was a very emotional issue that came up. It's the second time actually that we've had to look at this particular issue. At the end of the day, the council decided that we were going to keep our existing policy intact, and that is not to allow pigs as pets within the city limits. It was unfortunate. We had a family that has a pet pig, and unfortunately, though, they're going to have to make other accommodations for their pig. Some of the other things that came up at the meeting last night, we had several Lindenwood students that came forward and spoke to us about the new project on First Capital that is right now named Lindenwood Commons. It is a kind of a mixed-use retail development that is going to include, as an anchor tenant, a new Schnucks store, which will be approximately twice the size of the existing store. The existing Schnucks is about 40 years old and has reached the end of its life in that particular location. The students did a very good job. They came out and spoke about why redevelopment in this area is important to not only to their campus but to the city overall. And we certainly appreciate anytime we hear from students. One of the other issues that we addressed last night was we started planning for the snow plowing, and it is the fall of the year, and it's time that we need to get contracts in place to make sure that we had enough salt, as well as we do a public-private partnership with one of our local contractors here in town that helps assist us on removing the snow. So that worked out very well for us last year by using a private contractor as well as the city trucks. We were able to put a lot more pieces of equipment on the road quicker and get the snow removed in a much more efficient manner. Worked out very well, so we're going to do we're going to continue that process, and we entered into a contract last night to continue that. The other part of course, snow removal is making sure that we have enough salt. One of the ways that we're saving money on that is that we formed a cooperative with the other cities within St. Charles County, and we're buying salt in larger quantities now. By the time you batch both all the cities within it together, we get economies of scale and are able to buy salt at a much cheaper price. So that's working out for us. The other issue that is before us right now, and we have not made a decision on yet, but the issue of property tax rates has come up. Setting the tax rate is always an important step. We're very cognizant of any tax increases or any taxes overall, and the impact that it has on our city residents. We recognize the fact that right now the economy out there in the not only in the city of St. Charles, but nationwide, is not good. And we have a significant number of families that are faced with unemployment, and times are certainly tough out there. In addition to that, we have property taxes. All of our homes have been going down in value. And the implication of that to the city of St. Charles is if we our one of our main revenue sources that pays for public safety, fire and police in particular, is the property tax. The property tax, of course, is derived as a percentage that comes from the value of all the real estate within the community. With new assessments that came out, that those values went down in the neighborhood of 4%, and if we leave the tax rate the same, the city will receive less revenue coming in. What we're looking at right now is to determine if there's ways that we can cut cost without impacting public safety in particular, and still provide the level of services that our community has come to expect. It's a difficult issue. We're certainly trying to find other ways to cut expenses and raise revenues, do more with less, as everyone's doing in their home. It's something that we're working on, and I encourage people to contact their council members and the mayor's office and let us know what you think, because it is a very important issue. It will be addressed at the coming council meetings. Before we get into upcoming events, I'm going to flip it over to David Gibson, and David's going to talk about some of the other city meetings that are going on right now and other events. David?
Thank you, Mr. Klinghammer. An upcoming meeting I'd like to talk about is the Planning and Zoning Commission meeting. It will be held on Monday, September 26th at 6:30 p.m. on the fourth floor of City Hall in the City Council Chambers. On the public hearing portion of the agenda, there will be 9 items at the upcoming meeting. First is case CU-1911. This is an application for a conditional use permit for an expansion of an existing cell tower and compound within the I-1 Light Industrial District, specifically to increase the height of the tower from 50 feet to 100 feet. This property is located at 3967 Houston Road. The property is approximately 10 acres in size and is located in Ward 8. Second, we have case CU-2211. This is an application for a conditional use permit for temporary retail sales within the I-2 Heavy Industrial District. Specifically, this would permit a year-round snow cone and food stand with Christmas tree sales in the month of December in the parking lot at 3779 Newtown Boulevard. The property is 3.41 acres in size and is located in Ward 8. Third is case CU-2311. This is an application to renew a conditional use permit for an existing group home located at 13 Ridgeview Court. The property is 0.16 acres in size and is located in Ward 2. Next, we have case CU-2411. This is an application for a conditional use permit for temporary retail sales within the C3 Highway Business District, specifically to expand the use of a previously approved food stand at 1365 South 5th Street, which is Bass Pro Shops. The subject property is 3.75 acres and is located in Ward 2. The fifth case is case CU-2511. This is an application for a conditional use permit for temporary retail sales. This particular location would be selling, it's a barbecue food sales trailer that would be located at 1460 South Drive. The property is 1.35 acres in size and is located in Ward 3. Next, we have case CU-2611. This is an application for a conditional use permit for a group living arrangement within the R1C single family residential district. Specifically, this would be a group home for no more than 5 individuals at 612 Hemsath Road. This is adjacent to an existing group home facility, group care facility that's located within St. Charles County. And that location is 618 Hemsath Road. The property is just under an acre in size and is located in Ward 3. Next, we have case Z-1011. This is an application to annex and rezone 1.54 acres of land known as 940 Fernwood Drive from St. Charles County R1E Single Family Residential District to St. Charles City R1D Single Family Residential District. The property will be located in Ward 3 upon annexation. Next, we have case DR-1311. This is an application to amend Chapter 156, which is the zoning code of the City of St. Charles, by amending Section 156.161, Nonconforming Uses, and Section 156.162, which is non-conforming structures. The last case on the public hearing will be case DR-1411. This is an application to amend Chapter 156, which again is the zoning code of the City of St. Charles, by amending Section 156.743, which is our standards for electronic billboards relative to the maximum height of billboards approved through the I-70 corridor electronic billboard relocation process. If you have questions about any of these cases or anything the Department of Community Development handles, which is planning and zoning, code enforcement, and building inspection, please feel free to contact our department at 636-949-3222. Thank you.
Thank you, David. Appreciate that update. Next, I want to talk about a few events that are going on within our community. And one of the things that St. Charles is really good at is that we have a lot of free entertainment that is scheduled throughout the year. Tonight, we have Music on Main. Tonight it's actually Wednesday the 21st. Music on Main runs from 5 o'clock till 7 o'clock. It's in the North Main area. It's down on the 100 and 200 blocks of North Main Street. We bring in a band, close down the street, bring a band out. People bring lawn chairs, and we have some food and drink that everyone enjoys. It's a good time, and a lot of people decide to stay and have dinner down on Main Street as well. The other big event that we have coming on is Oktoberfest. That is going to be held on this weekend, the 23rd through the 25th. That event is held in Riverfront Park. Oktoberfest is one that we're very proud of. The Dan Faust is the president of that organization that puts it on. Dan and his team do a superb job. There is a lot of events that occur all weekend long down at Frontier Park. There's free music. There's dancing. There's a lot of cultural things that celebrate our German heritage. One of the events that is a lot of fun, they did it for the first time last year, was a dachshund race. They call it a winter dog race, and they actually have different categories of dachshunds, and it's a good time. Everybody really enjoys that. So if you're looking for something to do this weekend, I encourage you to come down and enjoy the Oktoberfest. It's another one that is very family friendly, and it is it's free for everyone to come and enjoy. With that, with those two announcements, I'll wrap it up at this time. Thank you very much, and we'll see you next time in a couple weeks. Thank you very much. Have a good day.